welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to go over the EDM style. Now, EDM is, it breaks down into so many subgenres that it almost becomes arduous as to calling it a subgenre. Think of it as a subgenre of pop. So it's a big kind of figurehead for all these genres that kind of combine anyway into what we call EDM, electronic dance music. It kind of is clear on what it does. It's electronically made and it's dance music, and that kind of simplifies the whole genre, you know. And it kind of, there's so many genres, it's unnecessary, let's be honest. And the point here is to say it's more of a pop thing. If you focus on the pop genre, there's no genre that's pop, it just is popular. And that's what we have to think about when we're talking about EDM. Same thing, what's popular in the electronic space, okay? Not is it house, is it trance, is it this, is it that. It's too much separation and it confuses you. Okay, so anyway, let's get into the structure of EDM. Now, again, I want to disclaimer here, this is not for beginners. So if you're a beginner, please go to busyworksbeats.com/beginners, and there you can find the beginner material to get you started into music production. This is not for beginners. What the stuff we're going to do is very high level. This is one of the genres that you're going to see almost every technique in music production applied. So you have to know a lot to really apply every aspect. So anyway, the basic structure of EDM starts off with melody for the most part. Then we get into a filtered rise. I'm going to show you how to do that. Then we drop into the bass, and it's four to floor drums. And then we kind of layer our synths and our chords after that. And we create different sections in the song to finish it off. And we're not going to create a full song because that'll take hours. What we're going to do is go over the four main parts, which is the melody intro, the filter rise, the drop, and then the main verse. And from those pieces, you can build out a song. So let's start with the drum selection. Let's go to our browser. And I have here under Club Drums, I imported the Vengeance Club Drums from refx.com. They have a lot of drum samples, which people use in pop music, EDM, a lot of the dance genres. And the most important part is the snares, the type of snares that they sampled. Now, some of these are 909 snares. Some of these are processed 808 snares, but it still has this kind of tail to the snare that's essential for the sound. Very long snares. So here are the snares I'm talking about. Very lightweight and long. So let's right click, open that up. So generally you want to just stick with one type of snare. You can be creative and come up with more, but for the most part, I'm looking for a lightweight, long snare, and those cover those frequencies. So now let's pick a kick. Now the kick isn't going to show up for a long time until the drop. Let's go to bass drums. Let's go to punchy kicks. I'm not looking for a clubby kind of bassy tailed kick, which has like a kick and then a bass tail. Kind of like a mini 808 almost. But if you do like the bass tail, that would be something tight and controlled that we can use. But again, you got to be very selective when it comes to your kick drum to make sure it matches your snares. Okay, so you really want to take the time. So that kick works, but let's go to the punchy kicks. That's a nice punchy one. Now notice the kicks are programmed differently as well. So it's a whole different synthesis process in which they create these sounds versus hip hop sounds. So they're just different sounds. Let's grab some hi-hats. Now some people like to grab loops, which is fine, but I find that the loops are very song idea specific, so they're not just like simple hi-hat rhythms. You know, it's very thought out process. And again, this is the club pack, so it's not necessarily a certain genre, but I found that loops work best for the house genre. So we're just going to stick with regular hi-hats. And now everything else, maybe a cymbal we can find, a crash cymbal. Let's cycle through the closed hi-hats to see what we would pick. Very short. We don't need anything long. That's nice. Again, you can get creative with the texture there. Let's go to the crash cymbals. We do need a crash cymbal to kind of be a big element on the downbeats. So a nice, long, drawn-out cymbal would be good. Okay, and an open hi-hat's optional. Now they're all different styles. You can do the or the tsk, tsk. Okay, more for house, you're going to find open hi-hats. So again, more specialty elements. You can go on and on for days about the sounds and the different snares, etc. We're not going to dig into the sounds further than that. So now we have our drum samples. Let's start to program a drum rhythm. So I said we're going to start with the melody. So let's just go in order so we don't confuse the process. Let's open up Nexus, which is like number one for EDM. The number one pick, I mean. Let's close out the browser. So we may get into sound design depending on where we're stuck as far as looking for sounds. But for the most part, Nexus is going to have the sounds you're looking for. Let's go to single layer leads. And let's go to a detune lead or a hands up lead. That's a little too low. Sounds like a low pass filter's on it. So this is going to be the element which we create our melody. So it has to have something about it that sounds cool. I like this one, but again, it sounds muffled for some reason. I like this one, hands up six. So let's create a rhythm. Now the melody can be very unique. And this, if you start off with the melody, this is going to help you get through the rest of the song in this particular case. Now there are different ways to work through a song, and we go over that in Beat Magic at busyworksbeats.com/beatmagic. But today, you know, start with melody to get your song idea across. Okay, so let's first tap out a tempo. So I'm going to go dun, 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 dun. Okay, so we're at about 115. So dance tempos are going to be 115, 118, 120, 122, 125, 128, 130, and then you start getting up into the higher realms there. 108 is another famous dance tempo, but we're going to stick around 115 for now. Let's go to the playlist and let's start building out our melody, which is going to serve as part of our intro. So this is going to be the thing which people are going to focus on. So before we get into everything, let's double click everything in the channel rack. Let's go to our mixer. Let's right click insert one, go to channel routing, route selected channels starting from this track. Let's go back to pattern one and let's start programming our melody in the playlist. Let's click the draw tool. Let's drag it out for about 8 bars. And we're going to do it in context. So let's right click, go to piano roll, turn on our metronome so we have a little contrast and we can measure what we're doing here. And let's figure out what we're going to do. So the first thing you want to do is figure out which sounds best to your ear. Which tone sounds best? That's it. Figure out which one sounds best first. I think G sounds good for this one. So let's start on G. Now the best part about EDM is you can have long drawn out notes or you can have very short notes, which are very rhythmic and repetitive. And that's what we're going to use today, very short notes. So here we're going to focus on the rhythm, not necessarily moving around the notes too much. And then we're going to contrast those short notes with long notes. And then we're going to go fast. Okay, so this is all an artistic way of spicing up the dun, 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 dun. So you want to really bank on your rhythm as your core foundation. This is the foundation of the melody. Everything else is extra. So this is extra. And we can repeat that, and I'm going to prove it by getting rid of this and doing something different. You can even continue your G notes. Okay, it's all based on the rhythm, not necessarily the note. So if you want to be more creative, you're going to fill in that gap. So we're going to change the notes. So it's the same kind of movement, but different notes. And that's how you can create variations in your melody. But again, all this stuff in pink is extra. We didn't need it. The foundation is the rhythm, not the note. So G, the rhythm on G is the melody. Now that didn't really work pitch wise because we're kind of getting out of the key. So without digging into music theory, just stick with the notes you've already used before to help you out. In this case, B was out of the key, so it sounded weird to the ear. Even this note here is not in the key, and that's why it sticks out. So let's move this up so that we start higher and we can keep everything in key without dipping out of the key. Okay, so now it sounds more in place. And again, we have tons of videos at busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. When you sign up with your email, you're going to get more music theory videos for you. And they go over the science behind that. Right now, we're just going to keep it simple and straightforward. So that is our melody. That's going to be the thing which drives us through the whole song. Now, also keep in mind that in Nexus, it has the delay and the reverb activated. If I turn those off, this is going to sound like a stale sample. So, you know, this is a mixing technique. When you see effects and different things, those are mixing techniques which make a sound sound better. So just keep that in mind. Okay, so that's the melody. Now you want to generally introduce some type of rhythm, okay, whether it's a hi-hat pattern or some type of, let's see. See our samples. Let's start with the hi-hat. So we're just going to do the tit, 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 tit. So let's right click, fill each four steps, and we're going to create a nice hi-hat pattern that's very basic, but it's going to create something we can measure the melody on, just like the hi-hat for the metronome goes tick, 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 tick. It makes the melody sound like it's doing something cool. So we need that kind of reference to our ear. And we're going to build a riser, but that's going to dig into sound design, so don't get too overwhelmed. But now we're going to add the snare. So here's our snare. So I'm just going to right click, fill each four steps. It's going to be a basic snare, kind of building our way up. And we're also going to use the riser to build up. So the next eight bars is going to be about building the energy level up, and I'm going to show you how they achieve that with just filtering. Now, a quick note is that when you're DJing to an already made song, the question is, how do you make the already made song sound different? You use effects like filtering, delays, reverb. So those are the things you're going to see for rises, you know, pitch changes, because that's what DJs can do to an already made song. They can raise the pitch. They can make it go slowly up or down over time. They can add filters. They can do those things. So it's more effect based. So that's the approach from a DJ's perspective versus a producer's perspective. And you have to apply that to your own song. Now, as we're going in the build, one quick tip you can use is to increase the frequency of your elements. Meaning, if we have a hi-hat pattern that's, hits every beat, we can double that. So let's clone this into pattern 3, and let's add that into the playlist, and we can make this go double as fast, so we can add in eighth notes. So the speed, the frequency of the hi-hat increases, and as we increase in frequency or cycles or occurrences per measurement, we assume that the energy is going up. Just like if you increase the pitch of a sound, it goes zzz, we assume the energy is going up. It's kind of like driving away, and you fly away. It's the same thing. Just increase the frequency, meaning the occurrence, the amount of times you have something hit. And that's a way to increase the frequency without changing the pitch. Now for the snare, what we're going to do is actually modulate the pitch, because we want the pitch to kind of glide over time or rise over time. Now without, maybe, you know, let's, I'm trying to think how we should do this. Let me see if Nexus pitch actually affects the sound. I think it does. So that's actually very good. So we're going to keep it Nexus based, so you don't have to worry about sound design, because I find that when I start going over sound design, it gets eggy and it gets confusing, and I'm not trying to confuse you, but I just want to make you understand that this is not for beginners. Okay, great. That pitch bend works. Okay, so that's great. So that simplifies a lot of things. So let's open up Nexus, and I'm going to show you how to create a riser effect with Nexus. Okay, so what we want to do is find a simple tone that we can hold. So a very steady tone. It doesn't have to be a special tone. It could be a simple layer lead. It could be a pulse wave, a saw wave. It could be anything. Let's try the classic Jupiter leader. Let's stay away from, getting tongue twisted. Let's stay away from saw teeth for now. Let's try a square lead. Let's do this one here. And let's send this to track 11. And what we want to do is hold a consistent tone all the way through. So it's vital that you understand the main key in your melody, which, remember, is G. So we're going to start on G for our riser. And this is important that we make everything kind of mesh together pitch-wise, because it will all sound together as we rise, as we go over the way to pitch rise. So let's right-click, go to piano roll, select G in a low octave, like G4 or G3, very low octaves. And you want to stretch this out for as long as you want it to last, so maybe 8 bars. Remember, we are in 115 tempo, so 8 bars will last about that whole area. And this area is what we call a pre-chorus. It's something to get us ready for something else. But some people call it the build. You know, since it's EDM, some people call it the rise or the build, because it's going to drop into the main verse, which it technically is not always the chorus. So technically, this is pre-something. It's a pre-drop, let's call it, or a riser. Okay, so now that we have Nexus at G, what we need to do is make sure that we set the pitch range to 12. It's vital that we set it to an even number of 12. I didn't mean to say even number. I meant to say one octave, which is 12 semitones, because we're going to make the pitch bend all the way up to an octave higher. And it's easier when we're modulating the pitch to know where we're ending and starting in pitch, so that we understand what key we're in, or key we're on at the time. So that's vital. Now the snare, you don't have to worry about the pitch as much, but just make sure we're changing the octave to 12. It's just a good way to measure your pitch movements. So now we're going to start adding modulation. I'm going to call this pitch rise snare. It's going to be the snare pitch rise, and this one's going to be the pitch rise for the riser. Pitch rise riser. Okay, anyway, so we're going to start modulating. So here's where we start to automate different things. Let's go into Nexus, which is our melody, and I don't mean to modulate the melody. Let's go into the snare. Let's right-click the pitch wheel, go to Create Automation Clip. This is going to create something which is going to control the pitch over time, called an automation clip. Now, the first thing you need to do is right-click and copy the first value. That's important. Before you start adding points, right-click and copy that first value. Now we're going to right-click a point in here and hit P to paste. So it pastes that 50% value. We're going to pull this end value all the way up so that the snare goes up in a total of an octave over that amount of time. And we can right click and paste. Now it's not so vital that the snare goes up an octave. We started at 12 to set a point. It's going to make more sense for more tonal elements. But for the snare, it's a percussion. It doesn't really have a tone. You can actually, I'll show you how to tone that down if it's too much pitch rising over time. Let's go to our riser now, which is Nexus 2. Let's right-click, go to Create Automation Clip. We're going to do the same exact thing. Right-click and copy that first value. Right-click a point in here. Right-click, paste, or hit P. Left-click, drag that point up. Okay, so what's happening is it starts at 0, and then it goes up to 12 semitones. So it's plus 12 semitones over that amount of time. So it's a nice way to measure where we're going. So 12 semitones is an octave, which means it's still G when we finish. Okay, it's rising to the note G over time. So here's what it sounds like raw. Now this is with the snare all the way up to an octave energy rise. Also, let me lower the riser's volume a little bit. Now, it looks like Nexus may have some kind of pitch range. Here we go. Okay. So in Nexus, these are the extra steps you got to take care of. The pitch range, you have to change this to 12 inside of Nexus. So again, a step that you might not know about. That's why the pitch bend is not rising as fast. So change that under mod, go to pitch bend range 12. So these are the little things which are going to, you know, be a big deal to some people. Now the pitch is going to rise much faster. Now at that point, the snare wants to go faster in our ear. The snare is going too slow at that point. So let's make this let's make it unique. So this is now pattern 5. Let's select these patterns. Click on the top left, select source pattern, pattern 5. So now these are all pattern 5, and let's make it go faster. It wants to go chick, 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 chick. So let's add those notes in between. And at this point, it wants to go even faster. So let's click on the top left, go to make unique. That's pattern 6. Let's change this to pattern 6 as well. Now we have to add in the gaps. So just left click and drag. So now we have those fast notes in between. Now for the snare, I'm going to lower the volume. It's just a little too aggressive at this point. Now what some people do is they'll do like a and then they'll kind of add some kind of element which stops it early. So let's. Okay, there's different ways to do drops. What I'm going to do now is kind of pause the snare at that point. So let's make that pattern unique, go in and edit the pattern and cut out the snares at a certain point. So that's the last snare I want. And then have something occur to where it's nothing there, but the snare does hit at that point. This will be a good place to add a cymbal. Let's go to a new pattern and let's find our cymbal, our crash cymbal. And then add that crash cymbal. Now I added this in a new pattern down here. Let's move this up so it kind of fits in with the rest of the drums. Call that cymbal. So I created that on pattern 9. And then we can do the drop here. But some people like to do the build and then do something in between and then do a drop. So your drop is up to you. There's different ways to do it. We're going to assume this is where we're going to add that gap right at the end here. Now the hi-hats, we want to make that unique and we want to follow the pattern. We want to get rid of that notation at the end of that section there. Okay. Now let's get into filtering. So filtering is common for EDM rises. So what you want to do is go to your master track, open up a parametric EQ2. We're going to left click on band 1, drag that down to a high pass shape, which is this shape here. And we're going to right click frequency and go to create automation clip. And that's going to do the same thing as the pitch bends. We're going to make the high pass move over time. So right now it's set to basically off. When it's at 0, it's nothing's happening. So let's right click and let's move this left point up. Now in this case, it's not going to go all the way up because it'll cut out every frequency. If you understand mixing, you'll understand that more. If you want to learn more about mixing, you can go to busyworksbeats.com/Mac, M-A-C, and you can learn more about mixing. But you don't want to put it all the way up because it'll cut out a lot of the frequency to where we can't even hear the song anymore. Notice how it already cut out most of the song at just the 50% mark. So let's pull that back a lot more. Okay, and then we restart. So that's the filter. Very subtle. You can make it more harsh by pulling that point up. But again, it starts to take away the weight of the song. So really be careful with your ending point for moving your high pass filter. So that's a quick, easy way to add a high pass filter shape for the build. Now let's get into the drop. So the drop is going to consist of the same elements basically as the intro, except this time we're going to have a bass element and a kick element. So let's go to a new pattern, pattern 11, and let's do what's called four to the floor kick patterns, which is basically we right click the kick and go to fill each four steps. The kick is going to hit each beat. So if you're familiar with music theory, a beat is every time the metronome hits. So if we go to pattern 11, every time the metronome hits, the kick hits. And that's called four to the floor. So let's add a track in here. Let's insert a track and let's call this kick four to floor. Very common EDM dance rhythm because it's easy to keep track of the dance style. You know, when you're a dancer and you don't know music. Okay, so that kick sort of works. Let's try the other kick, see if it fits better. That one gives us a little more bass element. So now we need to add a bass element, which is the whole reward for listening to the build. So let's open up Nexus again. Let's go to bass, and we need something that's a little bit detuned. You know, some people, let's click on dance bass just to be very stereotypical. That's not the bass we're looking for. Actually, this is a cool one because it gives, I like that actually. So let's go to 12. And we need to configure a bass rhythm similar to the melody rhythm. We need the bass to do something special rhythmically. Okay, it's not necessarily about the tone of the bass. So don't get caught up in the long drawn out notes for your bass. So I want to go doom, 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 doom. So let's figure out. So again, it's going to be on G because that's our starting note for the melody. So typically G is going to work. And we're just going to cycle through G and G sharp. It's a very common dance technique to just go up one semitone when you're dealing with the bass to create that clubby feel. Now it sounds weak because the filter's on. So don't worry about the sound right now. Let's just start the rhythm. Boom, 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 boom. Now, doesn't it look like a melody? Okay, it's the same principles which apply to the bass. And then we can repeat it just like we did with the melody. Now, we're not going to repeat the same thing over and over just like the melody. We want to create variations. Now, in this case, we can change that note. Just like we did in the melody, we had two sections, which were add-on sections, and we changed each of those. So here's the bass without the filter. So let's hit Control A, Control down, so we can hear this in the bass octave. And let's also turn this down in the mixer. It's a little loud right now. So that's what people are going to be waiting for when we hit the drop. So let's add that bass line in context of the song. Now let's hear it all the way through and hear where we can improve on the drop elements. Do we need an extra crash cymbal when we start on pattern 13, right on the downbeat? Let's add that. And let's add it over here. Now, a common technique before we get into the rise and drop is to omit any high frequencies. Just leave the kick and the bass for the drop. That's a common technique now used. So just keep that in mind. Sorry, I had the filter off, so let me do that one more time. And now you can see what the filter is doing over time. Okay, so a common thing is to add kind of fills right after the drop. So right at the end of the four bars, we're going to have the bass kind of do a do-do-do-do or some kind of fall. It could be a tom drum thing. It could be a snare drum. We're going to figure out what works best. Let's go to percussion. Let's see if we have any tom drums. There's so many percussion to choose from. I'm not going to spend all day. If we don't find what we need, we're just going to keep moving. So we need something like a tom drum. This could work. That could work as well. Okay, so let's not dig into too much percussion. But anyway, it's going to be at the end. So it's... Chicka-chicka. Okay, so we're going to omit the kick for that last section. Omit the bass. One. Okay, so let's slide that over a little bit more. And at the end, right at that, okay, the fourth section there, let me make sure we're accounting for these sounds too. So let's send this to track 13, mixer insert 14. And let's do the ending. So let's add this in context. Let me give this a track so we don't get confused. This is going to be the percussion fall at the end, or fill. Some people call it fill. I'm calling it a fall because I was thinking about pitch when I said that. So let's call it a fill. So you can use loop fills. You can use, I think some of the packs come with fills already in the loops. So you can check the loops folder for fills. I know the newer, you know, the house one had a fill section, so you could try that. If you're not, you know, good at programming drums, you could do that. So right at the end, we want to have something occur, you know, like a tom drum or a snare, whatever you want. Let's try snares. Let's right click. We want to give it pitch modulation, so I want to go da-da-da-da. So C to F over time. Hitting shift down to move those notes. Okay, so for the tom drum, we're going to do a similar thing. Just pitch it up, hit control up on the keyboard to move it up an octave. So I wanted to go da-da-da-da. So let's go to E sharp in this case. So again, the notes are different because I didn't tune this percussion, and I'm not going to spend too much time doing that. G sharp. If you don't know how to tune, you want to go to our video. It's free on YouTube. How to tune your instruments to any DAW. So just something to kind of wrap it up. Now that was a kind of a quick job, but you can do it with, you know, real drums, kind of drum loops. You could do different things. It's your creative touch to the song. So let's hear it again through the build and then through the drop. Some people, what they like to do, right when that crash hits, they like to bring the filter back down. So it feels like you're going from a high position back down kind of really fast. So you can right click right where that crash, right where everything stops. Right click, add that point. You can copy your endpoint there. So you copy your peak value, paste it, and you could delete your endpoint so that it goes back down to the lower frequencies. It feels like you're literally falling. It goes, listen to the riser. Feels like you're slamming into something, like you're falling into earth. And that's all because of the filter, okay? So these are the things which you need to understand. Now, lastly, let's add the chord stack. So the chord stack is optional. It's a something to go over the melody to kind of stack it. So let's add another instance of Nexus. Some people just like to ride their melody all the way through. Some people like to add pitch bends and really quirky sounds. You know, it's up to you. But right now, let's go to dance leads and let's go to dance saw maybe. Actually, some people like to use the same exact patch. So let's go to hands up six, I believe we picked. And now we're going to add chords. You don't even have to actually, let's do this. You don't need to open up a new instance of Nexus. Let's just keep this simple. Let's use what we already had. And let's go to pattern one. Let's make this unique. Change the source over here to pattern two. So now that's pattern two as well. Let's go to pattern two. And what we're going to do is create chords over top the melody. Now this takes a little bit of music theory. We have a whole video. It's called How to Make Long Chord Progressions. And we go through the different technologies involved in music theory and building chords. The first step is to build out a scale. So let's start with the scale is to help you build out chords. You don't have to do this, but it helps because we have sharps and different keys that you're probably not familiar with. So that is D sharp. And we're gonna go through all the notes that we used to keep it simple. Okay, so that's the scale for the most part. A scale is a sequence of notes which we like. Just to simplify what a scale is, it's a sequence of notes which our ear likes to hear. That's pretty much it. So it starts with D sharp, it stops with D sharp. Let's just clone that so we have two octaves of it. And that's our scale. We're going to call this the scale reference. So it's easier to build out chords when we get stuck. So now we need to figure out which parts of the melody do we want to have a chord stack. So the initial drop probably is going to need a chord. So let's assume G is part of that chord. Well, it is part of the chord. Let's assume it's the top note of the chord, however. So we're going to go to our scale reference. We're going to select G. I'm hitting Control Shift to highlight the notes. And we're going to skip every other note going down to create this chord because I assume G is the top note of this three-note chord. So it goes G, D sharp, C. Now, if it doesn't sound right, I'll know that G is something else relative. And let's shorten those notes. So it might work over here instead of the first note, maybe the third. Sounds good. But that D sharp sounds a little too, you know, cluttered for my ear. So let's assume G is the bottom note in this case. We're going to select G and skip every other note going up the scale. This is why I duplicated it in different octaves so we could do this easier. So it goes G, A sharp, D. And let's try this over here. I like that energy better because the chords, having the chords here instead of below it, it's an energy balance. You know, all our notes in the melody are in this area. Okay, so when our chords are in the same area, it fits better. The chords before were down here somewhere and it's not in that whole kind of boxy area. So this is just a quick way to think about it. Then we're going to have another dent. So it's every third note. Remember one, two, three, and then one, two, three. Now the note isn't at G, but technically G would be here if it were rhythmic. So it goes one, two, chord. Okay. Very basic, and we don't even have to build a lot of chords. It's just going to go on every third note of that melody. Looks like I put the wrong note here. But that is pretty simple, and that's how you can make it seem like chords are more active in your melody. Now, if I just showed you this and said copy this, you would think it was some complex thing. It's just a combination of simplicities. Now in the pattern, you want to make sure you're sliding the bar so that it doesn't have the scale reference overlapping. So now we want to add snare activity. Now that's rapid snare. We want the regular snare. So let's go to a new pattern. And let's figure out when our ear wants to hear the snare again, because it feels empty just having a kick. Now, which snare do we use for? Okay, we use snare 07. So let's go back to snare 007. It's funny how it's 007. I just realized that. So let's add this in. And let's change our snap to grid to bar mode so that it can fit better. So you don't have to have fills every time you have four bars, but if you like that style, you can keep doing that fill technique down here. All right, and we went through all the sections. We went through the intro, which is the melody and light percussion. We went through the build, the rise. We went through the drop and the cutoff effect, how to create that slam effect, like you're falling back to earth using a high pass filter. We went over the drop and we went over the main. This is pretty much the verse area. So you have all the elements you need to create an EDM song at this point. Everything else just comes down to creative decisions, like how you want it to change up, different things of that nature. And that's not so technical. So that is it for the EDM. I'm going to play it twice through just so you get a better idea of what we created. And you are going to get the project files when you click that link below and sign up with your email. So we decided to give out the project files. And again, click that link below. When you sign up with your email, be sure to go inside your email client and actually confirm your opt-in. Click the yes, subscribe me to the list button, and then you'll get another email with the downloads. Okay, so here's the project we created today. Okay, so mixing would take this song to a completely different level to make it translate over different systems. You can see the first time I had my subs on and then I A-beat it with my headphones and the song felt a little more flat because there's not so much bass hype. So again, mixing would take this to a completely different level. So if you want to learn more about mixing, go to busyworksbeats.com/Mac. You can learn about mixing there. If you want to learn more about the beginner stuff, go to busyworksbeats.com/beginners. If you're kind of skipping ahead and didn't listen to the beginning of the video. and click that link below and sign up with your email to get these project files for free. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com. Please like the video and please share with your friends so we can help more people around the world. It's busyworksbeats.com.